Good morning, folks. Good to be with you again this morning. Just another morning minute in the Word. We're in 2 Chronicles 7:14 this week. On Monday, we talked about how God said, if my people, which are called by my name, and we said there's some things that he's going to say in the middle of the verse, then at the end he says, then, if my people do this, then I will do this in response. Well, today we're going to look at the middle of the verse. What is it that his people need to do? If my people, which are called by my name, and he says, will humble themselves and will pray and will seek my face and will turn from their wicked ways, then, if my people will do these things. Listen, God expects us as his people, those of us who have trusted Christ as our Savior, it's up to us to humble ourselves, to come to God. I mean, it takes humility to come to God in a time of need. It takes humility to come to God and say, I'm not in charge. You are. I can't do it, but you can. I don't have the answers, but you do. And so when we are in trouble, when there are trying times around us, God's people need to humble themselves. And we need to pray. Have you ever had that kind of, you knew you needed help, but you were too proud to ask for it? Listen, we've got to humble ourselves before God, and then we've got to ask for help. We've got to come to him and say, God, we need help. God, we need answers during this time. Listen, during this time of COVID-19, I have seen so many stories about people requesting that everyone go to God in prayer. We've heard it from the president. I've heard of governors asking their states to have a day of prayer. I've heard of governors doing that, or mayors doing that, or just local cities saying, we need to call on God and make this a national day of prayer, or a city day of prayer, a county day of prayer. Listen, God's people should not have to be called on to do that. We should automatically be doing that. We should humble ourselves and pray. And then we need to seek God's face. It's not enough to say, God, please fix this, and go about our days doing whatever we want to do. We need to humble ourselves and pray and seek God's face, seek God's will. God, what do you want us to do? But then that fourth thing, and remember, he's talking to his people, turn from their wicked ways. What wicked ways have you let creep in over time? It probably didn't happen all at once. It wasn't that you went from God-fearing, God-honoring, going to church every possible time, reading your Bible every day, to then you're a murderer. Like, it's not usually like an overnight thing. There's usually things that come in little step after little step. What wicked ways have you let creep in? God said, hey, if you want healing, if my people want things to change, they've got to humble themselves. They got to pray. They got to seek my face. And my people need to turn from their wicked ways. I want you to think about that today. Is there some area that you need to humble yourself? Is there something you need to pray about? Are you not seeking God's face? Is there some wicked ways that have crept in? We all need to meditate on this and ask God to help us see the truth in this passage as it applies to our lives. We'll come back on Friday. And we'll see what happens when God's people put these four things into practice in a time of need, what God will do. If, then. So join us again Friday morning for that. Take care.